NTV kusawemu nkwaniriza nnyo munnaffe gye baleko ejyaleero. Amawulire ngenda gatandika n'emitwe mikulu egigalimu.
Bonna bawagira ekyokubuusako.
Kola bantu obusente bwa bafuna saawa zino tebuliwo.
Eri amagye, poliisi.
Parliament olwaleero lw'ekitegedde nti ensaasaanya ya UPDF ey'ekyama yalinnya okuva ku buwumbi 122 nga kati ya buwumbi 13. Bino bibadde mu alipoota eyanjuddwa omubaka akulira akakiiko ka Parliament akavunaanyizibwa ku nsonga z'ebyokwerinda, Benny Namugwanya Bugembe. Ono ategeezezza nti omubalirizi w'ebitabo bya gavumenti alina okwekenneenya ensaasaanya y'ensimbi zino.
Abaka ba Parliament bennyamivu ku ngeri omuwendo gw'ensimbi ez'ekyama ezisaasaanyizibwa amagye gye guduumuuza okuva ku buwumbi 122 okutuuka ku buwumbi 3 mu mwaka gw'ebyensimbi guno. Bino bibadde mu alipoota esomeddwa akakiiko ka Parliament akola ku nsonga z'ebyokwerinda mu kwekenneenya bajeti ya minisitule y'ebyokwerinda. Embalirira y'ekika kino teretebwa mu lujjudde era ng'ebitongole by'ebyokwerinda bikozesa ensimbi zino mu bintu eby'enjawulo omuli okugula ebyokulwanyisa ssaako mu by'obukessi n'okulwana.
Ng'ababaka ba Parliament tulagidde Office ya Auditor General ebeere ng'egoberera enkola eriwo mu mateeka erabe ng'etunula mu nkozesa ya ssente ezo.
Wabula minisita w'ebyokwerinda Dr. Crispus Kiyonga agamba nti eggwanga terisaana kweraliikirira olw'ensimbi zino.
Bwe muwulira nti bajeti ey'ekyama ey'edifensi egenze waggulu mubeere bakisanyufu kubanga kitegeeza nti mugenda kulindibwa bulungi.
Minisita w'ekisikiriza ku ludda olwabula gavumenti Mwanga Kivumbi agamba nti wadde ensaasaanya eno ya kyama naye beeraliikirivu ku ngeri ensimbi zino gye zikozesebwamu.
We also want Parliament to critically look at classified expenditure.
Uganda mu kiseera kino erina abasirikale mawanga muli Somalia gyali mu kulwanyisa ba Al-Shabaab, Central African Republic amagye gye galwanagana n'omumpembe Joseph Kony, ssaako South Sudan ng'eno gayambako mu kutebenkeza eggwanga lino.
Ebintu by'ogenda kukozesa ng'okuba omuntu omubi aze kukulumba tobiteeka mu mawulire nti ngenda kukozesa tanka bweziti, ngenda kukozesa enyonyi bweziti.
Alipoota era ekonye ne ku nsonga y'okuwummuza abasirikale abaagala okwabulira amagye. Kati akakiiko ka gala enteekateeka ennungamu etekebwa ku nsonga eno.
Twagala tulage bameka abaatuuka okwetayalinga, ssente zeetaagibwa ziri mmeka.
Kyokka Minisita Kiyonga agamba nti eggwanga lyetaaga obuwumbi 10 okusasula ensako n'obusimu bwabo abaawumuzibwa nga tebannabakagana nagwa kuwummuza balala.
Kikyamu kugamba nti abajaasi balala bawumule ate ng'essente ze tugenda kubawa nga tiziriiwo, ssente z'abali abaawumula dda nga tetunazisasula.
Naye Dr. Kizza Besigye omu ku abo abaliko mu magye agamba nti ensonga eno minisita gy'awa nnafu.
Ekya ssente si kye kibagaanye ne bwe ziba mmeka. Bangi nnyo abaagala omukisa ogwo naye tebaguba wa lwaki, kubanga ekituufu bali mu kkomera, tebaagala bafulume bawakanye, abamu bawakanye gavumenti by'ekola.
Okukubaganya ebirowoozo ku bajeti y'ebyokwerinda kwa kubawo ku lw'okubirwa ssabbiiti ejja.
Abantu abasula mu bifo ebirimu omugotteko ko n'ebyo ebiriraanye entobazi emitima gibasula ku mitwe. Namutikwa w'enkuba afudde mba ensangi zino yabaleetedde okweraliikirira. Kinajjukirwa nti abakola ku by'enteebereza y'obudde baalabula nti enkuba yakutonyera ddala okuva omwezi guno okutuuka mu December. Tutuuseeko ekyebando mu kitundu ky'ekisalosalo nga kino kye kimu ku bifo abantu gye basula batudde olw'enkuba etonnya kati kumpi buli lunaku. Eno y'embeera gye tusanze mu kitundu ekyo.
Ne ku makya ga leero ng'ennaku zino bwe kitera okuba, enkuba ekedde kutonnya mu bitundu bya Kampala ebisinga n'emiriraano. Tukyaddeko mu bifo ebimu ebitera okukosebwa enkuba. Amakanda tugasimbye kyebando kisalosalo ku njegoyego z'ekibuga Kampala. Mu kitundu kino enkuba buli lwetonnya abatuuze batuula ne bagirinda okukya, olwo ne badda mu kwera n'okusenda amazzi agabagalegamye. Abamu nga gabayingiridde ne mayumba. Ku kyalo kino Jaja Maria ow'emyaka 8 y'omu ku abo abakosebwa ennyo enkuba buli lwetonnya.
amazi gajula ate sisobola kugasena
olwaleero nno agamba tetonye nnyo era wetuukidde nga munnamuyambako okugasena alina kyakozeewo
sisobola kugasena omugongo gwandema gwalemalanga mbeera mu mazzi
mu nnyumba ebintu ebitonotono byalinamu yabiwanika si kulwanga byeyonoonebwa amazzi Jaja Maria wana amazewe miaka 12 agamba muwala we ye yamugulira ennyumba eno oluvannyuma lwa mutabani we okumugobaganya mu nnyumba ye emyaka gino gyonna agamba zaagumira embeera eno enkuba wabula kati agenda atende walirwa enkuba buli lwetonya naddala mu budde obw'ekiro Jaja Maria agamba asula atemya
gunyogoga mbeera bugendi ningamba ngenda gufa nindowooza tetugenda kunwa embeho genda kunwa
waliwo omukyala Maria gwe yasembeza n'amuwako ekisenge kimu ku nnyumba ze kyokka ono naye agamba asula kutebuuke
nenjoora ebintu nebiwanisabakesitogalawegawandise
buli lwetonya agamba tiwali kalimu nakamu ke basobola kwekolera wabula okusena amazzi mu nnyumba
okuva mwasanze nga njoora nekatera tetagalaba
Eno yemu ku nyumba za mukyala Maria. Ku budde obw'enkuba abapangisa bavaamu ne bagenda. Omusana we gwaka ne bakomawo. Kati abasigala ku ludda luli olw'ekisenge batera okujja enkuba bw'eba etonnye okujjamu gana amazzi galema ate bo kubayingirira.
Wano mu kitundu kyebando abatuuze balabika nga bamanyidde embeera eno. Si Maria nabeewuwe bokka ku muliraanawo nawe embeera tekyukako.
Amazzi gatuyingirira ne tuyisibwa bubi nnyo obunyogovu era tuba tugatambuliramu
essanyu ly'abantu beeno kwe kulaba ng'enkuba ekedde balyoke balongoosa awaka bano ennaku yaakubayonka butaaba olw'ensonga nti abakugu mu by'obudde baategeezezza nga bwegenda okufudde emba okutuukira ddala mu December Gertrude Tumusiime Witkware NTV
Webale nnyo munnaffe Gertrude Tumusiime Witkware. Abagoba b'ebidduka abeegattira mu kibiina ki National Union of Drivers, Cyclists and Allied Workers balangiridde nga bwe bavudde mu nteeseganya ze babaddemu ne KCCA ez'okugonjoola obutakkaanya obuliwo wakati waabwe ku nzirukanya y'ebyentambula mu Kampala. Bano bagamba nti ensonga bazongedde wa President Museveni nti alabika y'anaasobola okuzigonjoola.
Bino byonna bibaddewo mu nsisinkano y'abavuzi b'ebidduka mu kibiina kyabwe kibagatta nga basala entotto ku bigenda mu maaso naddala engeri KCCA gy'esoluzaamu emisolo ku batakisi. Bano bakkaanyiza bukuyege okuva mu nteeseganya ezaateekebwawo oluvannyuma lw'ensisinkano yaabwe n'omuduumizi wa poliisi Kale Kayihura Rwebedima okusaabaza abantu.
Tusazaamu enteekateeka zonna ezibadde zigenda wakati waffe ne KCCA nga zisinziira ku ebyo IGP byesalawo. Naayimiriza akakiiko ka TAPSCOM n'ebikolwa byako byonna ebyali bigenda mu maaso n'abiyimiriza.
Naye kya nnaku okuba nti KCCA eggwanga lino erifudde nti lyayo nti ebintu byonna bye bakola bewaddeyo okulaba nti bajoonyisa omuntu omuntu ajja tuuka eseera yeekola ekintu.
Bagamba ekyakkaanyizibwako ng'okutaba naabwe bali mu makomera n'okubaddiza emmotoka zaabwe ziri ku poliisi tekyakolebwa.
Abasibe abali e Luzira KCCA yagaana okusindika abaligo baloya baalyo ogenda okutuula n'akakiiko ke baateekawo akasayidi ne State Anthony okulaba nti bataasa abantu abali e Luzira basibibwa obwereere.
Kati ensonga bagamba bagenda kuzongerayo wa President Museveni.
Ekyokubiri babongeddeko n'amaanyi ate agasinga agalulu nti babongedde n'empingu.
KCCA bw'eba nga ye managing traffic nga bwe bagamba etteeka bwe liri tekitegeeza kujja mu paaka kusolooza.
Wabula wetuukiridde kaakulira ekibiina kitasikumu ekyateekebwa KCCA okusolooza emisolo gya taxi mu Kampala yasinse Matimba agamba nti kino tekibayigudde ettama.
Anti IGP bamulimba nti ba taxi kati kitata kiba kizibu okwogera ebya taxi kati atuuse ebya taxi bituuse okwogerwa tabisobola.
KCCA etegeeza nga bwetannaba kutegeezebwako ku nsonga eno.
Ebyo bye boogera simanyi we babijje nti amannya ag'abantu be twabagamba okutuwa tugayina naye nga balina otuwa chairman, balina otuwa secretary era nga tukyabalinda.
Mu lukiiko olwakubirizibwa omuduumizi wa poliisi Kale Kayihura, enjuyi zombi abalondebwa baweebwa omwezi gumu okugonjoola ekizibu kino. Ivan Kimuli Kigozi, NTV kusawemu.
Nsonga ya byantambula mu kibuga Kampala. Amawulire ge twakafuna okubala abantu kwongezeddwayo olunaku lumu nga kati mu kifo ky'okuggwa olunaku olw'enkya okubala abantu kwakomekkerezebwa ku Sande. Ebisingawo okuggulira eryo mu birindirire mawulire gaffe agesawa esatu. Zaabu kye kimu ku byobugagga mu nsi muno ekikyasinze okubeera eky'omuwendo ennyo. Kati okumala emyaka mingi eky'obugagga kino kiyikuulwa okwetooloola ensi yonna. Uganda yemu ku nsi ezo zinnamukisa ezirimu zaabu. Disitulikiti y'e Mubende yemu ku ezo zaabu gyali mu bungi era bwe twogerera bino ng'abantu bangi abasenga mu kitundu ekyo okusima zaabu bagaggawale. Kyokka ate waliwo abawakana nti zaabu erudde eyo taliiyo. Mu kitundu kyaffe ekisooka mu mboozi gye tutuumye zaabu e Mubende tugenda kukulaga emitendera abalombe bano gye bayitamu okusima zaabu ono.
Byafaayo bituufu oba byankalakkalira ku ky'obugagga ekimanyiddwa nga zaabu. Wabula ebimu ku byafaayo ebizze bitaganjulu biraga nti emyaka nga 1500 emabega zaabu ono we yazuulibwa. Butuluuki, Misiri, Nubia ne Roma zaabu gye yasookera era nga bamweyambisanga ng'ensimbi mu kusuubula. Zaabu kintu kya muwendo ddala era n'ebitabo ebitukuvu nga Bayibuli nabyo bimutendereza. Kale emyaka egyo gyonna eky'obugagga kyekimu kibadde mu ttaka lya Uganda wabula nga tekizuulibwanga. Mu myaka gya 1905 ne 1906 ebyobugagga ebitonotono nga ne zaabu mwali byali bitandise okuyiikuulwa mu bitundu ebitali bimu mu Uganda. Ensozi z'olengera zitumbidde ziti zisangibwa mu disitulikiti y'e Mubende. Wansi waazo zitudde ku byobugagga 10 wabula mu byo mwimuli ekisinga ettunzi, obuganzi n'omuwendo. Zaabu. Bulijjo tulira byogere engangala bya nnyanzi nti abantu ba bulijjo beegabanya dde ebibanja awaliza wabu era basima. Twabitaddemu engatto yogayuga ku kyalo olujinji mu ggombolola y'ekitumbi okwerabirako n'agaffe. Nga wakayingira enkambi eno tolema kulowooza nti oliko ekizinga ekijja w'ogobye. Ebikolebwawo, abantu ababeerawo n'embeera zaabwe byonna byawufu ddala. Okuwoggana kw'ebyuma ebikola omusinde n'okuyitingana kw'abantu bikulagirawo nti kifo kijjudde okukola. Kati okitegedde nti basimi ba zaabu wabula bamujjawa batya era lwaki atuusizza ekifo kino okubeera nga kirimu enkuyanja y'abantu. Okusima zaabu kutandika na mutendera ogw'okuzuula ekifo zaabu w'asuubirwa okubeera. Kavuna olwazi lubeerako olunyiriri oba veyina eddugaaliridde kaba kabonero akalaga nti zaabu waali. Basimira ddala okukka wansi nga beeyambisa ebyuma ebiyitibwa makta nga bwe bagoba olunyiriri lwa zaabu oba veyina. Wakati wa futi 36 zaabu aba atuukiddwako wabula si buli ky'olaba nti aba zaabu.
Kayita muno nga bw'olaba tujja tugaziya ne tujja nga tuyitamu ne tuserengeta nako. Kati wali waali we kali tukirya nako ne tukka wansi.
Kibeetaagisa obwegendereza bungi obutasima mpuku mu ngeri eyinza okugisuulamu.
Naye kati wano twerekereza ne tulekawo empagi ne tutakubayo gundi eno ne tutakubawo layini eno gitwala. Empagi esobole okubeerawo enyweza ekintu kino.
Wansi eno kifo kya bunkenke ddala kyokka abakolayo batono okuba abambala ebintu ng'ebikoofiira oba gambutusi.
Wansi eno gye tuli kyenkana tugenda mu fuuti 10. Naye nga abasima zaabu mu kitundu kino bagamba nti mpewe sibwa yokka yeyinza okubasalako okweyongerayo wansi eyo.
Ettaka erijjibwa wansi eno lye liyitibwa omukyanga era we lituukira waggulu abaguzi baba baalinze dda. Ebbaafu egula okusinziira ku buka bwa veyina esimibwa era bw'eba sinovu bulungi baafu eba wakati w'emitwalo 2 n'5. Sokafu nebange esubirwamu ekyamaanyi eyinza n'okupaala n'etuuka kakaddakamu.
Ogenda ng'osampolinga omukyanga gw'olaba nti mulungi n'ogusuubula n'ogutransportinga n'ogwabaana ne bagwetikka ne baguleeta ku luggya. Kati bwe baguleeta ku luggya kati nga kino ky'olaba wano Oteka matundu bali n'ogwanika bulungi ne gukala noteka ka abaana ne bakola katingo y'obwomulaba ne bakuba amayinja bwova wano kitera nti kuva gukazi n'okutwala ku kyuma.
Abeetikka omukyanga be bayitibwa boda boda. Ekyuma kino kikubira ebbanga eriwerako okufuula omukyanga akawunga olw'okwoza ne kuddirira.
Bamala okwoza, mu kwoza kuno bakozesa bbaafu, ne mu bbaafu mbateeka mu makire. Mu makire oyo bamuteeka mu bbaafu ne bayiwamu omukyanga pawuda awedde okukubwa ku kyuma ne batandika okwoza. Olumala okwoza, ekivudde mu mukyanga guli abeera golodi eyeekutte ku makire. Oyo ayoza n'akamula, akozesa katambaala kayiwamu makire akwatibwako golodi. Nakamula
buli mutendera gukolako asasulwa bubwe. Wabula Vincent agamba nti omulimu guno gwa mukisabu kisookukwasaamu ekiwera. Oluvannyuma lw'okwoza tewali kisuulibwa ate waliwo abaguzi abalala abajja ne basubula omukyanga bano gwe bajjeemu zaabu. Enkola esinga okwoza omukyanga ogukozeeko yeno magezi g'Abaganda eyakazibwako erya Z oba ngalia.
Wetekako angalia ogwo ne babyoza kati bamala okubyoza nga bamaze weba ne bateekako amakoti yago ne bajjako ne batwala wali emmanga ne bateeka mu bbaafu ne bakunkumula amakoti yago olumala ogakunkumula ate ne boza bupi eri mu kinya.
Olunaku lwonna bayinza okufunamu gramu eziri wakati w'omunaana n'ekkumi gy'emitwalo nga 9 egya Uganda. Kigambibwa nti zaabu ava muno y'asinga okuba omukwafu. Kafuna bino byonna biggwa afunye atwala awali abaguzi ne bapima kyaleese n'asasula ensimbi ze awatali kubanja. Waliwo emirimu emirala njolo egikolebwa mu birombe bino okuyambako omulimu gw'okusima zaabu okugenda mu maaso. Lindirira olunaku lw'enkya omanye engeri obulamu bw'abalombe buno gye bubeerawo na mirimu ki emirala egikolebwa mu kitundu kino. Solomon Kaweesa, NTV.
Zaabu emobende webale nnyo Solomon Kaweesa. Mulindirire ekitundu ekirala olunaku olw'enkya. Songa waliyo n'abatategedde Luganda waliwo ekitundu mu lulimi Olungereza ku ssaawa 3. Tugenda ku mulamu katono NTV ku ssaawa emu ekomawo n'ekitundu ekyokubiri bino bye bimu ku bikirimu. Motoka ya President Uhuru Kenyatta emisinde kwe yatwaliddwa mu Kenya gyalesa abantu be Busia nga bakomba nfuufu. Muzungulu, Otunu yandibanga afuuse mmemba wa kwaya ate abavubuka abatalina mirimu baagala gwa Kayihura.
Olugero lwaleero lukutuusibwako Movit okwekakasa ku lunaku lwonna.
Enkalubo ekira amaluma. Okulya amaluma waakiri ogoma n'ennyama ekaluba n'owutamu omukyuzi. Sanyukiranga ekitono kyonna ky'oba olina kuba si kya buntu bulamu okukola olunkulu.
Okwekakasa ku lunaku lwonna.
Love your walk, your smile, your laugh, everything.
You know what else, babe?
What?
You smell.
Oh no, I'm out of airtime. Shops are closed. I have to wait till tomorrow before I can get airtime. Ah, she would think I was saying she smells.
Get airtime instantly with your phone.
What?
Just use Airtel Money. Dial *185#, select buy airtime, and follow the steps.
What?
Sorry, babe.
My line got cut. I was just saying you smell better than
any flower in the world.
Top up with Airtel Money and get 100% bonus airtime instantly with every top up made. Now that's 100% extra from Airtel. Dial *185# to top up now.
Airtel Money. Simple, secure, instant.
What's up? Feel it within.
For the first time ever in Uganda, it's the Kampala Horse Ride. On Friday the 5th of September, 92.7 Bob FM, your total country station, invites you for the first ever Kampala Horse Ride. Starting off from Wandege at 3 p.m. with the march all the way to Katikati, where there'll be loads of fun activities and live country music from the legendary Michael Owuma. Entrance is 20,000 shillings ordinary and 50,000 shillings VIP. The Kampala Horse Ride, powered by SMS Empire, NTV and MTN.
Twesimye okubanga okyali naffe ku NTV ku ssaawa emu. Akawungeezi ka jjo, mmotoka ewerekera Pulezidenti wa Kenya Uhuru Kenyatta eyakwekulwa kuno yaziddwayo mu Kenya. Kino kyakoleddwa wakati mu bukuumi obwabadde obwa waggulu ddala nga ne speed motoka eno kwe yabadde evugirwa wamago yabadde ekirako eyakaweewo. Abasirikale b'ekitongole ekirwanyisa obutujju be bawerekedde motoka eno okujituusa ku nsalo e Busia. Bo abamu ku bantu e Busia ababadde balindiridde okulaba motoka eno yabayiseeko nga tebategedde era balabiddaawo ng'enfuufu esaanikidde ebbanga. Ebyewuunyisa mu buyindi tebigwayo nga twakamala okulaba abafumbirwa embwa okusobola okwegobako ebisirani ate mu ggwanga eryo lye limu eriyo omusajja mukulu ow'emyaka 6 eyeekoledde erinnya mu ngeri ekyalemye bangi okukkiriza. After Mawoni afuuse wattutumu lwa kitambala kyasiba ku mutwe mulwe waabwe kye bayita Tabana. Ono akisiba ku mutwe n'akirako eyeetisse olusozi era nga buli waayita aleka abantu bamunyenyeza mutwe.
Mu mambuka g'eggwanga lya Buyindi mu kitundu ekiyitibwa Patiala ewasangibwa musajja mukulu ono Atta Singh Mawon ono aweza egy'obukulu 6 naye nga ekimufudde ow'ettutumu nnyambala ye. Aliko ogutambala ogunene mu lufutufutu gwe bayita Taban gwateeka ku mutwe. Agamba nti ekitambala kino kiweza obuwanvu bwa fuuti 2215 ng'okyanjuluzza. Musajja mukulu ono agamba nti kimutwala essaawa 6 mulambo kukyesiba kyokka nga kino takyekaanya kubanga bw'ati wayagala okwambala. Okwewala okukalubirira abantu abalala ono yasalawo okutambulira ku pikipiki. Agamba nti ogutambala gwonna ebintu ebira by'enaani kanga atambula bireeyo mu pawundi 10 kiramba. Mawoni nga Sheikh Mulamba bw'agenda mu nsinzizo mu kitundu kye Patiala afuuka ekyokunyumyako eri baabasanzeeyo era nga waliwo n'abaagala okumutuula okumpi. Tekikoma okwo, bw'aba afuluma wabweru waliwo abamutega nga baagala okwekubisa naye ebifaananyi. Ono agamba nti wakwambala bw'ati mu bbanga ly'anaamala ng'akyalina amaanyi agasiba ettambaala lino. Ayina likodi y'ensi yonna mu kitambaala eky'ekikula kino ayitibwa Major Singh nga naye wa mu ggwanga lya Buyindi.
Ebintu ennaku zino mu Uganda bigenze bichuka nga kati buli mbeera eriwo ya katemba mwerere. Mwenno abali ku mulimu gwa katemba bwe muteefeeko nnyo mwattu emirimu abagisobola bangi. Abeekalakasa mu Uganda bwe batadde katemba mu nkola zaabwe kisikiriza ne bannakatemba bennyini okuvaayo beekalakase olw'akatemba waabwe alinnyirirwa. Abakulu bano beekalakasizza era byabadde biri awo katemba n'atuukira ku mulamwa gwe babaddeko olwo ne tusoberwa Zungulu.
Zungulu akutuusibwako Skin Guard.
Skin Guard is for
everyone. You come to the center.
Yeyauta supu wabanansi mukatale.
Yali enkoko embisi bayita mukamoli.
Kasile kama sindisi binyo bali walierwa.
Yekadi ya Zungulu.
La, Antonio, la.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
And hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Iyo kwaye yimba ne kumbaga bannange, mutukubira ne tubawe namba yabwe. Otunu naye yafuse memba wayo.
Bannakatemba bakoze katemba mu kwekalakaasa kwe babaddemu bwe bakulukusizza amaziga olwa firimu ze bazannya okutundibwa siringi 5 n'olunaana. Mbadde nti bannakatemba ate lwaki ogamba nti bakoze katemba?
Abaana ba Isirayiri wabayambisa balaja lwaki totuyamba? Tuwali emirimu gyaffe tuyo gyaffe gavumenti esiba etugenda tukole.
Kitalo. Katemba wafafa bannange. Nduuza kesi z'abafuna gwa musono gwazze mu kwekalakaasa. N'eggolola si bwetyo gye yaleese. Mbumu agenda okuteeka omumerika gw'agenda okuttira mu ringi ku lw'omukaaga. Tubalinde ate olw'enkya luli wala tunaalaba ddirayo mu kkeesi. Bw'anaabaggolola tunaamusaasira nga bwe tusaasira Lukwago ne biggweera awo.
Mpulira y'ennaku zino bangi abagamba nti mwana waffe Lukwago ng'olabye ng'obonyeebonye.
Obonyeebonye bambi wuuyo mu kkooti omusaala gwa mmeeya tokyafuna. Kyakutambuza ssebo. Okyasaaga ejja okuddamu okunoonya omulimu ku street okuwandiikibwa mugende musome science
ne President Museveni byayogera ntino
febeka kali
lwakufula scientist is an art
in fact babiyita military science.
I want Kaginas job.
Olabikolo bandi jangu ye va mukuliikaana.
No na yimbako dane mbipo wane.
Njobbe ebintu mu motoka zaabo. Omanyi abavubuka nammwe amaaso gabakanuse bulala. Si mmere eri ku kyoto, si nkoko, buli kamu mukabba. Olaane mbidi muzibba. Kalumba Steven, for example, weka mengo ku lwe Masaka. Hobo otye mbizi ya Nalongo nambi.
Na waka wawe wajajawe. Yonna bayo baganti.
Kati okwewala okumwokya. Abadde mukyama.
Kalumba, twala ye kizibiti waligwe, embizi z'abandi zonna ennume ozimaze ku kyalo.
Zungulu abadde akutuusibwako Skin Guard.
Bwe tukozesa Skin Guard, tukuumibwa.
Byonna mu Zungulu. Mu mawulire amalala ge twakafuna, America ekakasizza nga akulira Al-Shabaab mu ggwanga lya Somalia ng'ono ye Ahmed Godan attiddwa. Kino kidiridde ennyonyi za America okulumbagana Somalia ku ntandikwa ya ssabbiiti eno ne zisula ebikompola ku mmotoka omusajja ono mwe yabadde yatambulira. America egamba nti okutta omusajja ono buwanguzi bw'amaanyi mu lutalo lw'okulwanyisa aba Al-Shabaab era ng'abadde omu ku abo besinga okwetaaga. Mezanyo, NTV Kosawem.
White Star Laundry Bar Soap with a lemon fragrance, and you'll have a fresh, clean day. Be like a star. Use White Star. White Star Laundry Bar Soap, all day fresh clean.
Stand up to be counted. Brought to you by UBOS. It's your right.
Mom, why closing the doors and windows?
As if you don't know. Don't you see those people coming? They have been asking everyone questions in the village. I don't want to give them any information about us. You can't trust people nowadays.
We need to answer them.
Why?
They are collecting information that will help our community in the end. The information collected is used by our leaders to make informed decisions and plan better for all of us.
Census is here. Get ready to be counted. Starting from 28th August to 6th September 2014. Together, we count. This message is brought to you by Uganda Bureau of Statistics.
Close-up deep action. We created it to give the world three times fresher breath and eliminate up to 99% of germs. Maybe we went too far. There's an outbreak of freshness. Now the best ever from Close-up. Three times fresher breath.
Cooper Motors Corporation Uganda Limited is Uganda's reliable distributor for New Holland tractors, combine harvesters, case construction equipment, planters, rotovators, all readily available and backed up by full manufacturer's warranty, genuine spare parts, and highly trained service staff to ensure ongoing technical support for your machinery and equipment. Cooper Motors Corporation is Uganda's leading and most reliable agriculture equipment supplier and partner. Find us at CMC Building, Katalima Loop, plot 48 to 49, Nakawa.
Must Watch is brought to you by
Just a little Lux. Ignite the spark, Lux Soft Touch.
Oh, Muli Rwanda.
Walero.
Muli Rwanda. Oh, Muti Mobutwala.
Walero.
Muli Rwanda. Lamantu Sano Kulwala.
Walero.
Muli Rwanda. Oyongera Kupala.
Introducing softening silk essence and delicate floral notes in the all-new Lux Soft Touch for irresistibly soft, fragrant skin. Just a little Lux. Ignite the spark, Lux Soft Touch.
Ebyemizanyo kwen TV bikutusibwako.
Smart, the new mobile network for new Africa. Let's talk.
NTV kusawe mo negetu kujide monsike yebye mizanyo. Moses Golola na umumerika Abraham Richard gwagenda okubagana na ye uluna korencha. Olwaleero bapimiddwa obuzito bwabwe. Kizuuliddwa nti Omumerika asinga Golola obuwanvu nga ne mu buzito nabwo namwo tamubunyamu amusinzaako kiro mukaaga namba. Wabula wadde nga guli gutyo, Golola agamba nti kino tekimuyigudde ttama era ye alinze kadde kuvuga olunaku olw'enkya Omumerika amusomesa essomo.
Beetegekera okugasimbagana olunaku olw'enkya okwepimisa okukoleddwa olwaleero mu Kampala kulaze nga Moses Golola bw'alina kiro 71 ate nga ye Richard Abraham gw'agenda okumegana naye alina kiro 77 Omumerika era asinga Golola obuwanvu kyokka nga ye agamba nti bino byonna tebimuyigudde ettama era alina olunaku lwankya.
Nze ni international fighter kati yano kwalana n'abantu abali international ji ranked number 2 teka tinze musinga so nze okulwana n'oyo muzaja wa danwanye nanga nyinji ndeita bwana nkuna kula Moses gula Moses nangi mutya ida desima ichigenda kuli nangi chide chibuze ne wabula koze training omutima gwe gukakamu sabika tonda koze buli echeta agisa.
I can't wait, you know, to start
It's gonna be me and him in that ring. So, you know, I'm not much for words. I know he likes to talk a lot, but I like to do my talking in the ring. So.
Abraham aina nzanya asatu nga yakawangulwa mu bbiri zokka nzanya abiri mu omunana ze yakawangula mukaga kuzo yagonda abantu mu ngeri eyatonziriranga golola aina nzanya abiri mu bbiri era nga yakawangulwa mu bbiri zokka oluzanya luno lugenda kuba lwa round 5 era nga anawangula wano wakuvuganya ku tisipi kyensi yonna ng'omwaka guno tegunnaggwako.
Gabadde mawulire ga byamizannyo era NTV ku saawa mwe y'olwaleero bwetyo bwegenzo balikobeera mulabi mulungi tova ku NTV birungi bingi bijja binyuma tovaawo.
We are optimistic, positive. We are building today a brighter tomorrow by realizing our potential. Let's talk. We are SMART, the new mobile network for new Africa. Let's talk.
English Premier League's greatest stars is brought to you by
Guinness. Discover a world of more.
Discover a world of more.
NTV, turning on your world.
With Omo First Action, simply collect Omo wrappers, take a Mubaso Kuria Manyago, and drop it at the nearest collection point. Tosuwa! Omo Eka Wunderuno! Mama, mama! Washing with Omo has never been more rewarding.
Huh? Nice moves, Floydo.
Try it.
Told ya.
Check out the new Fanta Orange, now with an even better taste.
Order Fanta.
Introducing softening silk essence and delicate floral notes in the all-new Luxe Soft Touch for irresistibly soft, fragrant skin.
Just a little Lux.
Ignite the spark, Lux Soft Touch.
Easy times.
My brother, my sister, you don't hear? The Easy Dimes account is made for students because everything is free. Free ATM card to swipe around the world. Just flash your card like an order and enjoy many, many discounts. You also get free transactions so your money no go chop at the end of the month or when you use your ATM card. Yeah, so you even get a free checkbook plus free internet and mobile banking. Easy Dimes is built for dreams, so start saving and get plenty, plenty money.
Stand Big Bank, moving forward.
Ariel claims to give us the best stain removal in one wash, so we'll collect tough stains. Red sand, fruit juice, chocolate ice cream. To see which gives the best stain removal in one wash, we'll wash one half with Ariel and the other with premium detergent. Did the other premium detergent remove these stains? And Ariel? Yeah! Ariel, best stain removal in one wash.
This is NTV.
Hi, my name is Dr. Ronnie Meche Gwang, and for the next 30 minutes, you, me, we are going to be together as we watch one of the biggest duels ever on television. This is going to be a challenge between two of Uganda's finest academic institutions. They're going to be squaring it off. They're going to be discussing issues of monetary policy, fiscal policy, financial concepts, you name it. It's all going to be right here on this stage. What's going to be up for grabs? Well, the opportunity to walk away with your head held high. A chance to say that you've got swag. What about millions of shillings in academic bursaries? All that and more, ladies and gentlemen. But before we kick off the competition, I've got one simple question. Will you take the challenge? Welcome back to Challenge, powered by Bank of Uganda. And even you can get involved in all the fun. You can follow us on Twitter, you can check us out on Facebook, or actually you can go to our website. But better yet, why not play the game live here on this TV station? You know, what are they playing for? They're playing for money. And a lot of people are wondering, man, oh man, when I get my money and I want to send it to people, what can I use? Well, there's so many different platforms that you can use. And what's going to happen is that during the case of the show, we'll probably give you a chance to find out more about them. But when we're finding out, you actually need somebody to answer questions. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to our contestants in today's semi-final on The Challenge, powered by Bank of Uganda.
It's West meets Central, as in Tari School, renowned for OBs like His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, and Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, renowned for OGs like former Vice President Specioza Wandira Kazibwe. The prize is a place in the final.
It's another one. Welcome back to Challenge, powered by Bank of Uganda. For the next couple of minutes, I'm going to be hanging out with the ladies from Mount St. Mary's Namagunga. Hey ladies, how are you doing?
Fine.
Ladies, are you ready to take the challenge?
Yes, we are.
Okay. And ladies and gentlemen, we've got Intare School. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Guys, you guys ready to take the challenge?
Yes, we are ready to take the challenge.
All right, good. So, before we start off, what's your strategy for today's show, you guys?
We want to keep focused.
Yeah.
We want to do our best, and God will do the rest.
And ladies, what's your challenge, by the way? Huh? How are you guys going to prepare and win this one here?
Well, just setting this place on fire.
Setting this place on fire.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have fire extinguishers on standby because Mount St. Mary's is going to be on the rampage. The first category is just as usual. We have got what they call cumulate. Hands on the buzzers, please. It's going to be the fastest fingers that can activate. You answer the question correct, I give you 10 points. You get the question wrong, life moves on, and I can hand it over to the opposing team for them now to recoup 5 points. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's play Cumulate. Question number one. Which of the following can cause a rise in inflation? Mount St. Mary's Namagunga.
D is correct.
They are on the board. Next question. The process of calculating what Uganda shillings received in the future are worth today is called? Yes, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga.
A.
Calculating the yield to majority is incorrect. I hand it over to Intare School. Would you like to take the challenge?
Yes.
For 5 points, what is the answer?
Answer is D.
D.
D, none of the above?
Yes.
Unfortunately, it's called discounting money. But life goes on. Ladies and gentlemen, next question. A dash is a vehicle used by prudent, resource-rich countries. Thank you very much for getting my attention and subtracting 5 points from your score. Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, are you ready to take this challenge?
Yes, we are.
Can you please give me the answer?
A, sovereign wealth.
That is correct. They have got 10 points, ladies and gentlemen. BOU's inflation target is? Yes, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga?
A, appointed.
A is correct, ladies and gentlemen. They have got 30 points, ladies and gentlemen. Next question. Currently, the bank rate is... Thank you very much once again. Please let me finish. Please take off another 5 points from Intari School. And then we continue. So, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, would you like to take the challenge?
Yes, we're taking the challenge.
What is the correct answer?
A.
A is the same as the central bank rate. That is not correct. But would you like me to give you the challenge, Intari?
Yes.
What is the correct answer?
The answer is C.
C is correct. It's 4 percentage points higher than. So we give them 5 points. Next question. The buildup of risk in one part of the financial system that spreads to other parts of financial systems at a particular point in time due to common exposures such as interbank borrowing is known as... Yes, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga? What's it going to be?
D, contagion risk.
That is correct. Let's give them 10 points. Ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of this category. This is what we call cumulate. And as the scores stand, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga is at 40 points. Intari is at -5. But trust me, these are just numbers. Action is coming up. The next round we have is called Odd Man Out. This one is a round robin. Please take your fingers off the buzzers. I'm going to start it off with you, Intari School. Question number one. Okay? Odd man out. Commercial bank lending rates could rise because of the following. Okay? Which one is the odd man out and why?
The answer is A.
The answer is A. That is correct, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give them 5 points. But the question is, why?
Because the other three are reasons why the commercial bank lending rates,
yes,
do not rise.
Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, would you like to have a chance to get 5 points?
Yes.
Go ahead. Kindly explain it. Sir. Why?
You don't explain. Mm-hmm. A is the correct answer because when the government uses T-bills to borrow money from the public,
yes,
they're reducing the money in supply, and this will raise the rates.
Let's give a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Let's move on, ladies and gentlemen. The next one. Which is the odd man out with respect to SACCOs and why?
Okay. The answer is D. Credit rating efficacy does not apply to SACCOs.
Thank you very much. Let's give them a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. They get their full 10 points. That is very good. So, that brings us to the end of this category. As it stands, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga is in the lead with 40 points. Intari School with 15 points. This segment coming up can actually be what they call a game changer. Ladies and gentlemen, we call it memorize. We ask you only to focus on the screens and remember what you saw. There we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Those are your images. So, let's kick it off. Timothy, what did you see?
I saw Crane Bank.
You saw the Crane Bank logo?
Yeah.
That's correct. Let's give him 10 points, ladies and gentlemen. Emily, what did you see?
The Centenary Bank logo.
You saw the Centenary Bank logo. Let's give him 10 points too, ladies and gentlemen. Capacity, what did you see?
I saw a Western Union logo.
Western Union logo, let's give them a huge round of applause. 10 points to that. Nikita, what did you see?
10 shillings coin of Bank of Uganda.
That is correct. Let's give her 10 points. What did you see, Emma?
I saw a Barclays logo.
Barclays logo, that is correct. Let's give them 10 points. What did you see, Nisa?
I saw that note for 10 rand.
Note for 10 rand from which country?
South Africa.
That is correct, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give it 10 points. Back to you, Timothy. What did you see?
I saw a logo of Cairo Bank.
Logo for Cairo Bank. That is correct, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give a huge round of applause. How much is it? Back to you, Emily. What did you see?
A pound.
What did you see?
A pound. A note. A pound.
A note for a pound. What denomination?
Was it 100?
That is... What's the denomination?
10.
10 pounds? That is totally incorrect. So you're lying about what you saw. So please dock them 10 points. What did you see?
I saw a 20 pound note.
20 pound note from which country?
Great Britain.
That is correct. Let's give them 10 points, ladies and gentlemen. Back to you, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga. What did you see? Hard drive is empty? Ntare School. Did you see anything else?
I saw a Bank of Uganda note with Idi Amin.
You saw a Bank of Uganda note with Idi Amin. What was the denomination?
It was 20.
20? Thank you very much for lying to me. Let's remove 10 points from Ntare School. It was actually 50. Ladies and gentlemen, did any of you guys see anything else? Did you see anything else?
No.
Mount St. Mary's Namagunga in a slim lead of 60. In Ntare School, 55. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a huge round of applause. This is what you call the challenge, powered by Bank of Uganda. When we come back, I'm going to be playing a brand new game. This is the semi-final. We're introducing a totally new concept, but to see it, you gotta be there. So, we'll be back right after this.
Use White Star Laundry Bar Soap with a lemon fragrance and you'll have a fresh, clean day. Be like a star. Use White Star.
Don't disturb me. My dad is in a star.
White Star Laundry Bar Soap. All day fresh, clean.
22 artists. 44 collaborations. 5 countries, 9 episodes.
Coke Studio, baby.
The biggest show in Africa. This is Coke Studio Africa Season 2. Coming soon on this station.
Stop tapping and start shaving. Introducing Gillette Blow 3. Its open blade, easy rinse design gives you cleaner blades for a smooth shave. No more tapping. Gillette Blow 3. Cleaner blades for a smooth shave. Gillette by P&G. Everyday quality brands.
Good morning.
Good morning.
For every morning to be a good morning, all your baby needs is your love. And a dry night's sleep. New Pampers with more super gel. It locks wetness inside, keeping it away from your baby's skin all night long. Pampers, wishing you love, sleep, and play.
Must Watch is brought to you by
Just a Little Lux.
Ignite the spark, Lux Soft Touch.
Oh,
Introducing softening silk essence and delicate floral notes in the all-new Luxe Soft Touch for irresistibly soft, fragrant skin.
Just a little Luxe.
Ignite the spark, Luxe Soft Touch.
Guinness. Discover a world of more.
Mama's cooking. Let's help her.
Wait. My mama says before touching food, you should wash your hands with soap.
But my hands are clean.
I can't see germs, but they're everywhere.
Look under special blue light. To protect against germs, I recommend regularly use soap. Safeguard removes millions of germs and additionally it inhibits regrowth of germs that might cause skin rashes for hours.
That is why me, mommy, daddy, and my brother regularly use Safeguard.
Supported by the African Medical Association.
How are you guys going to handle going forward there? What's your strategy going forward?
We are cementing our team. We're making it stronger now.
What are you going to do?
Swap.
All right. And who are you going to swap?
Nisa.
Nisa. And you're bringing on?
Benna.
Benna. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for Benna. And a huge round of applause for Nisa. Team Intare. So how are you going to handle the pressure and cool down?
We've mastered the game.
You've mastered the game. All right. So I wish you guys the best. This is a category where you're going to need to have a very level head. We call this advantage. So, Mount St. Mary's Amagunga, who's your strongest player?
Emily.
Emily, walk on down. Let's give it up for Emily from Mount St. Mary's, Namagunga. Tari School, who's your strongest player?
Timothy.
Head on down. Ladies and gentlemen, question one. I hand it over to you, Timothy. Currently, there are no non-tariff barriers in the East African community. True or false?
False.
That is correct. We give them 10 points, ladies and gentlemen. Question to you, Emily. Nationals of Burundi, Uganda, Rwanda, and Tanzania are not required to pay for work permits in Kenya. Is that true or false?
True.
That is correct. It is 1-1. Rebasing the GDP is one of the ways that countries expand their economies. Is that true or is it false?
It's false.
That is correct, ladies and gentlemen. We give 10 points to Intare School. The governor and the deputy governor serve fixed 5-year terms in office. Is that true or false?
False.
That is correct, ladies and gentlemen. Timothy. Prior to the economic reforms in the 1990s, Uganda was the only country that had fixed exchange rate, capital controls, and sovereign monetary policy. True or false?
False.
That is correct. You have got 3 out of 3 so far. Let's give a huge round of applause to Intare School. The Bank of Uganda mainly adjusts the reserve requirements for prudential supervision purposes. True or false?
True.
That is correct. It is 3 out of 3, ladies and gentlemen. Unbelievable. These guys are totally on fire. So, let's play advantage, sudden death. All members of the Euro area are members of the European Union and vice versa. True or false?
False.
That is false. You are correct, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give another 10 points to Intare School. The risk of disruption to financial services that is caused by an impairment to all or parts of the financial system has the potential to have serious negative consequences for the real economy. Okay? So tell me, what is this? Is this cataclysmic risk, a perfect storm, systemic risk or sovereign debt risk?
C.
Systemic risk is correct, ladies and gentlemen. Namagunga has 10. Can't you guys fail something? What image of a traditional regalia is depicted on the silver foil of a 50,000 shilling note? A, barkcloth. B, shields. C, cowrie shells. D, spears.
It's B.
Shields. That is correct, ladies and gentlemen. Your question, Emily. Bank of Uganda controls the extent of credit creation by commercial banks through cash reserve requirements is not wrong at all. Let's give her 10 points, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! That is 10 points. Ladies and gentlemen, we have completed all the questions. There's nothing we can do. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Head on back to your team. Unbelievable stuff. Timothy and Emily. Aye. This is what we're talking about. Pure action, adrenaline at its best. But, you know, at the end of the game, there can only be one winner. Because as we speak, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga has the slimmest of leads, 110 versus Intare's 105. Right now, it's still anybody's game. Because we move on now and play a brand new segment. We call it All or Nothing. Simple. I give you 5 questions. You answer all 5 of them correct, I give you 50 points. You get any wrong, you get nothing. And then the opposite team can take up the question and get 25 points. Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, will you take the challenge?
Yes, we'll take the challenge.
Let's hear it for Intare School. Will you take the challenge?
Yes, we'll take the challenge.
All right, let's play All or Nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, question goes to Mount St. Mary's Namagunga. Money has 4 roles. 1, medium of exchange. 2, standard of preferred payment. 3, store of value. And 4, as a unit account. All those are roles of money. Is that true or is that false?
It's false.
It's false, okay. Treasury bills are considered a more liquid asset than gold. Is that true or false?
It's true.
Okay. The 1,000 shilling transaction fee being levied by some forex bureaus is a BOU requirement. True or false?
It's false.
It's false. Israel uses the Israeli dinar as their currency. Is that true or false?
It's false.
It's false. A mutual fund is a depository institution. Is that true or is that false?
False.
False. Ladies and gentlemen, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga were asked to answer all 5 questions. If they got even one wrong, they will not get the 50 points. But unbelievably, they got every single one right! 50 points to Namagunga! That takes them up! Whoa! Unbelievable but true. The challenge has been thrown down. If you look at their scores right now, they had 160 big ones, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, versus Intare at 105. Will you take the challenge, Intare School?
Yes, we'll take the challenge.
Now you seem intimidated. Your questions, Intare School. Vehicle and house insurance rates are regulated by the Ministry of Finance. True or false?
False.
All commercial banks give out credit cards to customers. Is that true or is it false?
True. It's true.
In computation of a country's GDP, government purchases like services of government workers are included. Is that true or is that false?
It's true.
Okay. Mexico. uses the pesos as their currency. Is that true or false?
It's true.
The Bank of Uganda only employs economics graduates. Is that true or is it false?
False.
False. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we also gave 5 questions to Intare School. Out of the 5, if they got any wrong, they now lose the full 50, and they hand over the opportunity, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, to earn themselves 25 points. I'm very happy to say, ladies and gentlemen, that they got 4 of them correct and 1 wrong. That means I give you nothing. Mount St. Mary's, will you take the challenge?
No.
You guys are chicken. All right, ladies and gentlemen. The question actually that you did get wrong, Intare School, is the question about credit cards. One, credit cards are not just given out to everybody. And some commercial banks don't even have credit cards. Ladies and gentlemen, as we stand, Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, 160 points. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Intare School, 105 points. Big round of applause. Now, where do we go from here? We head to one of my personal favorite rounds. This is a round where I can make you some money. Fingers on the buzzers. Question 1. Under fixed exchange rates, a BOP surplus will lead to a dash in money supply at the central bank, dash in order to maintain the fixed exchange rate. Yes, Intare School?
The answer is C.
C is correct, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give them 10 points. A policy that is effective in changing national income and is available only under fixed exchange rates and not flexible exchange rates is Mount St. Mary's Namagunga.
D, an exchange rate policy.
No, that is incorrect. Intare School, would you like to take the challenge?
The answer is B.
The answer is B. Let's give them 5 points, ladies and gentlemen. Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, 160. Intare School, 120. There is still time for them to catch up. Next question. The International Monetary Fund and the Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development collaborate on Uganda's economy through... Yes? Intare School.
The answer is B.
B is incorrect. Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, I'm giving you a chance to put 5 points on the board. What is the answer?
A.
A is correct. Let's give 5 points to Namagunga. Ladies and gentlemen, we are done with the semi-final. Let's give it up to Mount St. Mary's Namagunga. Winning this round here with 165 points versus Intare School with 120 points. Huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, what a game. And now in terms of cash that's going home with these ladies and gentlemen, we've got Mount St. Mary's Namagunga, who walked away with 5 points times 5,000. That gives you how much?
25,000.
I see you don't know math, but it's okay. You're not too bad with the economics, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give a huge round of applause to Mount St. Mary's Namagunga. And let's give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for Intare School, who are walking away with 15 times 5,000 shillings, which gives you?
75.
All right, 75,000 shillings. Give a huge round of applause. It has been a killer game. Mount St. Mary's Namagunga took this competition with 165 points. Intare with 120. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Come on down, come on down. Woo! This is what we call a game show. Ladies and gentlemen, now we've got our finalists for the Bank of Uganda challenge. This is too cool for school. But before I tell you about the final, I've got only one question. Will you take the challenge?
Hey, I will rejoice and be glad. and gentlemen, Jesus came to set you free and to be free indeed.
In life, you don't wait.
Yeah.
There are certain times where you wait for certain decisions, but when it comes to taking action and choices, you have to move.
Jesus Christ found me, and he actually asked me a question, whether I wanted to live or to die.
Every day of my life was struggling. It's just that God has given me this kind of hope.
GXP every Sunday only on NTV, your official inspiration station.
NTV, turning on your world.
Grants to Uganda and the arrest of top ministry officials. Today, improvements in handling these funds and the registration of vivid results in the control, especially of malaria, has resulted into a positive response from the Global Fund. Irene Namialo, NTV.
Moving on, the leader of the Somali Islamist group Al-Shabaab, Ahmed Abdi Gudani, was killed following a U.S. attack earlier this week. The U.S. carried out airstrikes on Monday night, targeting a convoy in which he was traveling. The Pentagon press secretary is quoted as having said that removing Gudani from the battlefield is a major symbolic and operational loss to the Al-Shabaab. Abdi Gudani was one of the U.S. State Department's most wanted men. Pentagon press secretary Rear Adam John said the military action on the 1st of September had led to his death. Counterterrorism officials and analysts have described Gudani as a particularly ruthless jihadi leader who eliminated several rivals within the Al-Shabaab, either by killing them or forcing them to go underground. The Al-Qaeda-linked fighters want to overthrow the UN-backed Somali government and frequently attack government targets as well as neighboring countries that provide troops to the AU force.
Thank you.
We will take a break and return with these stories shortly. An 80-year-old woman tells the story of braving continuous Kampala floods. Dewa Okope and Adolf Muhumza continue bossing the Uganda Golf Open Championship. NTV Weekend Edition continues shortly.
You are watching NTV Weekend Edition.
Is the number one internet provider, giving you the fastest internet speeds everywhere. The most affordable data bundles on the market. Guaranteed customer care whenever you need it. And countrywide coverage so you can have the best internet experience in Uganda. Simply dial *133# to buy an internet bundle. Internet changes with Orange. Today changes with Orange.
To survive the test of time, buildings need to be strong and able to withstand the forces of nature. Tiantang Group has introduced TTG TMT bars, hollow sections, MS plates, manufactured using top quality raw materials with the latest technology on Ugandan market. TTS bars are strong, weather resistant, 100% weldable, easy to bend at any angle, and are marked TTS. So look for the mark while buying.
Tiantang Group. Quality steel, normal price.
Over the years, my NSSF has had some good days and some difficult ones. But through it all, they have persevered to achieve some major milestones. They have given me better tools to take control of my future. Doing better is what they stand for. They made a promise to me, and they are keeping it. My NSSF listens when I speak. I feel more connected to my NSSF because they put me first, and I'm confident I will be paid all of my savings. I also know my savings are secure and are being invested in the best way possible, which means that I get the best interest on my savings to turn my dreams and ambitions into reality. And I don't mean to brag, but my NSSF is pioneering some of the greatest ideas our nation has ever seen. But what makes me really proud is that my NSSF is supporting those making a difference in my community. So how is this important to me? Simple. It's the comfort of knowing my NSSF is doing better for me today than ever before to give me a better future.
NSSF, a better future.
Regal Paint. Paint it, love it.
You are watching NTV Weekend Edition.
Welcome back. Now in the financial markets, the shilling posted some marginal gains against the dollar, closing 2600-2610 compared to the previous close of 2608-2618. Players in the energy and telecommunication subsector dominated greenback demand, while foreign direct investment flows helped on the supply front. We have more in this report. Meteorologist Department has issued a forecast showing that the current heavy rains across the country may go on until mid-December. While this may be good news for farmers, it is bad news for people in areas with poor or no drainage systems at all. NTV visited some places in Kampala synonymous with floods during heavy rains. Gertrude Tumsimo Witkware now tells the story of some families in Cheba and Ochsalosalo, a Kampala suburb that routinely floods.
This is Cheba and Ochsalosalo on the outskirts of Kampala. The continuous Friday morning downpour in Kampala that went on for more than half of the day had devastating effects on this city slum. Trenches nearly overflowed, which was a blessing in disguise for residents here to dispose of their garbage and open up their septic tanks to free sewage. Many compounds in this wet neighborhood flooded, with water freely flowing into some houses. Strangely, the residents in this Chebando neighborhood seem used to such scenes every time it rains. 80-year-old Maria Mukarujero is one of the residents who, over the years, have borne the brunt of the rains here. Thank God, the rain on Friday morning was not as heavy. Otherwise, her room would be akin to a swimming pool. By the time we arrived, her helper had already done some work draining the water from the house. On rainy days like this, Maria hangs up her few belongings to keep them dry. She has lived here for 12 years now. The elderly lady's daughter bought her this house after her son threw her out of her home. She's suffered with the floods for many years now, but Maria now feels that she cannot take it anymore. But the challenge is that she has nowhere to go. She houses another lady in one of the rooms in her house. It's this lady who normally helps her out. The situation in this lady's room is not any different from that at Maria's. On days like this, she says they don't do anything else but drain water from the houses. There is another of Maria's rooms which had tenants, but they shifted to escape flooding. Maria's sad story is shared by the rest of the neighborhood. With nowhere else to go and with little help, the people here have learned to live with their tough situation.
While to people like farmers, rain is a blessing, to some others like Jaja Maria, it is total disaster. Comes with so many things that she keeps dreading, for example, disease, living in the cold and living a totally uncomfortable life. Gertrude Tumusime Witkware, NTV.
Unfortunately for Maria and families like hers, they will have to brave that deplorable condition until about mid-December. Now, a remote village in Mubende district has been considerably transformed over the past decade after its residents started extracting and selling gold to wealthy business folk. Lujinji village in Chitumbi sub-county is bustling with activity thanks to gold mining. In her first series of Highland of Hope, Solomon Kawesa looks at what the locals go through to mine gold.
Historical records suggest that early civilization discovered gold about 4,500 years ago. The early empires of Greece, Egypt and Rome extracted gold and equated it with power, beauty and cultural elite. The precious metal is mentioned in sacred texts like the Bible, where people made idols that they worshipped. Geologists have over the years discovered lots of gold on the earth's crust. In Uganda, the British explorers are said to have discovered it in the 1950s. These hills of Mubende do not only enhance the area's scenic beauty, but also store wealth in form of gold deposits and other precious stones. For quite a while now, gold mining has been the work of choice for many unemployed people in Mubende district. We set off for Lujinji village in Chitumbi sub-county to see how the occupation has changed the lives of the locals. On arrival, we couldn't help but notice the bustling little town with its emerging structures, rumbling machines and its busy people.
It was clear right at the outset that the area's economic activity had transformed the area. It's gold that has given this once remote village the feel of a big town. The enterprising spirit of the residents aroused my curiosity, especially the procedures they use to get the gold. The whole exercise begins with knowing what a gold vein looks like on a rock. The miners dig tunnels to track the line of the vein. They place taplings around the tunnel to avoid rainwaters from running in. I followed the miners inside this scary tunnel to witness them search for gold. The digging is a meticulous procedure that's done with a machine called a makta. None of the miners is wearing protective gears despite the risky environment they are in.
We are about 100 feet deep into this tunnel. According to the miners, it's only oxygen supply that can bar them from digging deeper to look for this precious bin.
The soils dug off the vein are locally known as muchanga. Scores of buyers scramble to pay for it after it's brought to the surface. A basin of soil containing few deposits goes for between 20,000 and 50,000 shillings, but it can shoot to millions of shillings for soil samples that contain lots of gold.
No good transporting and no guava and bagwetika, the baguleta kuruja. The bagueta kuruja cutting at you no chola bawan. Oteka matundu by no guanica burunj, negukala, no teka kaba, nan bakola katingo yo bom lava, the bakuva my india. Bovawanu. Chita and tiguva gukas, no kutwala kuchum.
The gold dealers have to pay for different services at every step of the procedure.
Bama lokoza mukoza kuno bakwesa bafu ne mbafu mbateka machure machure oyo bamuteka mbafu ne bayiwamo omuchanga powder awedde okubwa kuchuma ne barandiko okwoza olumalo okwoza oyayoza nakamula akosa katambala kayiwamu machure akwatibwako gold nakamula.
The soil is not discarded after it's washed because people come over to buy the residues, hoping to get more gold. These ones use a locally made machine nicknamed the Z, simply because of its shape like the letter Z. In a day, Hassad and his colleagues can get between 8 to 10 grams of gold, which translates to about 900,000 shillings. After all this, they take what they have go to the buyers in the mines who pay upfront. Besides mining, there are many other activities which take place in this area linked to the gold business. In part 2 of the Highland of Hope series, we'll explore the other businesses that have emerged. Solomon Kawesa, NTV.
Thank you, Solomon. Now, Motormouth kickboxer Moses Golula is at it again, vowing to bid to pulp an American he's scheduled to fight on Saturday. But will Golula deliver? And as you ponder over that question, it seems opposition Uganda People's Congress Party President Olara Otunnu may soon become a member of a church choir since he's sharpening his vocal abilities. Over now to Agnes Nanduti for this and more in this week's episode of The Lighter Side of News, Point Blank.
Proudly sponsored by
Skin Guard is for everyone.
His ears bite off.
Hey, hey, hey.
I am the man who can just look at the woman and she gets pregnant.
You should leave issues of the generals to the generals.
You want another rap?
Yeah, Susan.
I am your presenter, Agnes Nandutu. But before we continue, here are the main points in this Point Blank Bulletin. Musicians demonstrate against piracy as UPC President Orara Otunu joins President Yoweri Museveni in singing. Now to our top story. You may think somebody has died here, but these are artists protesting and asking government to enforce the copyright law to end piracy in Uganda and protect their inventions. Be firm, my brother. No situation is permanent. Elsewhere, President Yoweri Museveni's remarks that art subjects are useless rubbed some people the wrong way, including this group of arts graduates. They demonstrated and burnt their degree certificates and graduation gowns. Ah! But why are you burning the document you would use to secure that elusive job?
So I want Kaihura's job. Wherever it is, I want Kaihura's job. I want Kaihura's job.
One by one, or you shut up.
We have a statement that says, res ipsa loquitur.
I beg your pardon?
Res ipsa loquitur.
What does it mean?
Facts speak by themselves. Facts have already shown that this government has failed to cater for the people.
Shut up. At this rate of demonstrations, we need God's intervention. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
King of kings and Lord of lords!
Hallelujah!
Forever and ever.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. As we join UPC President Olara Otunu in celebrating Jesus. Moses, the big talker, will need Otunu's prayers to overcome Richard Abraham.
I'm training for Richard Abraham. Whatever time I close my eyes, I see Richard Beers getting rover. I say, I'm catching that man.
As you dream to defeat him, we did not see you training this time round.
I've been training when mosquitoes are sleeping. That's why you don't see my training on the YouTube.
All right, he's already here.
Last night I didn't even sleep. Waiting to see Richard Abraham here.
See you in the ring. That is Gorilla Moses for you. Our beloved President Yoweri Museveni first showed his singing skills during 2011 election campaigns. And here he comes again. As we approach 2016. Job well done, Mzee Wakazi. You are a great leader with a great sense of humor. Another rap. Agnes Nandutu, Point Blank.
We work so hard, but we are never protected.
But with Skin Guard, we are protected.
Skin Guard is for everyone.
The Uganda Bureau of Statistics has extended the National Housing and Population Census by a day. The extension follows disruptions from the heavy rains and the abandoning of work by several enumerators in Kampala and neighboring districts. The exercise was meant to end tomorrow, but has been extended to Sunday, Ernst Wisdom Chionga reports.
Officials of the Uganda Bureau of Statistics in charge of the census resolved in a late evening meeting to extend the 6th September deadline by a day.
Our biggest problem has been the heavy rains, which have been experienced throughout the country.
But no extra money will be given to the enumerators and supervisors for the extra day of work, since according to the Bureau, no additional workload will be given.
Extra payment will only accrue to those enumerators who have finished their piece rate, and you will be required to be moved to other enumeration areas to assist in completing the workload.
Honorable members.
Meanwhile, Minister of Defense Dr. Crispus Chionga has told Parliament that the President's office has sent emissaries to South Sudan to intercede for Moyo district leaders who are arrested while enumerating Ugandans living across the border.
There is a delegation going from the office of the President and Minister of Foreign Affairs to ensure that our brothers are released and brought back home.
Moyo District Chairman Jimmy Okuda and Resident District Commissioner John Abingwa were detained in the neighboring country, where they had gone to secure a release of census enumerators arrested by South Sudanese authorities. Earlier, legislators from Moyo, including Ubongi MP Hassan Fungaru and Tom Azza of West Moyo, urged the government to intervene in the matter.
Census enumerators have been taken hostage by the Sudanese authorities. Reasons being that they have encroached on their land and therefore they have trespassed.
The border row between South Sudan and Northern Uganda has been running for over 5 years.
In 2009, a ceiling 600 million road work construction for smallholders agricultural productivity was also stopped. And in the same year again, health workers who are going on a routine immunization were halted in their work.
The census, earlier scheduled to end tomorrow, is Uganda's 10th national enumeration exercise, the 5th after independence, and the 2nd organized by the Uganda Bureau of Statistics, UBOS. Ernest Wisdom Chionga, NTV Weekend Edition.
Thank you, Ernest. Now, the Kenyan president's escort car that was recovered on Thursday morning in Kampala arrived in the Kenyan capital, Nairobi, under heavy security. The car spent Thursday night in Busia at the county commissioner's office. The black BMW 735 series crossed into Kenya at about 5 p.m. on Thursday. This after leaving Uganda's capital, Kampala. It was paraded at the Flying Squad headquarters in Nairobi, where the media was allowed to take photos of the vandalized car. It is time for another break, but I'll be back with NTV Weekend Sport.
You are watching NTV Weekend Edition.
use White Star Laundry Bar Soap with a lemon fragrance and you'll have a fresh, clean day. Be like a star. Use White Star. White Star Laundry Bustle. All day fresh clean.
Stand up to be counted. Brought to you by UBOS. It's your right.
Mom, why closing the doors and windows?
As if you don't know. Don't you see those people coming? They have been asking everyone questions in the village. I don't want to give them any information about us. You can't trust people nowadays.
We need to answer them.
Why?
They are collecting information that will help our community in the end. The information collected is used by our leaders to make informed decisions and plan better for all of us.
Census is here. Get ready to be counted. Starting from 28th August to 6th September 2014. Together, we count. This message is brought to you by Uganda Bureau of Statistics.
Looking to buy a car in Uganda? Find more cars on sale than anywhere else. Visit jeki.co.ug on your computer or mobile device. Simply search, find and contact seller directly. Find thousands of cars from dealers, bonds and private sellers.
You can find it at
jeki.co.ug, Uganda's number one car website.
Dad, you said we could paint today.
No, you actually remind me of myself when I was your age. I actually asked my dad the same thing. I want you to remember two things, trust and quality. So you see, there can only be one choice. Sadolin, color your world.
Cooper Motors Corporation Uganda Limited is Uganda's reliable distributor for New Holland tractors, rotavators, all readily available and backed up by full manufacturer's warranty, genuine spare parts, and highly trained service staff to ensure ongoing technical support for your machinery and equipment. Ebo Agriculture Equipment Supplier and Partner. Find us at CMC Building, Katalima Loop, Plot 48 to 49, Nakawa.
Eight top clubs, the world's best lineup. Is we ask, we lead their own club to make a breakthrough. 2014 International Champions Cup. Journey
makes them feel and
NTV Sport
is brought to you by
Smart. The new mobile network for New Africa. Let's talk.
Welcome to NTV Weekend Sport on a night when the group stage of the Africa Cup of Nations qualifiers begins. Now 28 countries are chasing 15 places at January's finals, with Uganda's Group E rivals Togo and Guinea set to clash in a few minutes at 10 p.m. local time. An Ebola outbreak in Guinea means that the match will take place in the Moroccan city of Casablanca. Guinea will be without Florentin Pogba, the older brother of France international Paul Pogba. Florentin injured his calf during Saint-Etienne's 5-0 drubbing at the hands of PSG. Lyon striker Mohamed Lamine Yatara and Lorient midfielder Abdoulaye Sadio Diallo are the other absentees for Guinea's national elephants. The Cranes will play host to Guinea next weekend. The team is currently in Kumasi, Ghana, ahead of tomorrow's AFCON qualifier. The latest news is that the Ghanaian FA has allowed fans to watch the match that kicks off at 7 p.m. at no cost. Let's move in now, because the Maroons Football Club has tonight accepted to feature in Ugandan football's second highest division, otherwise known as the FUFA Big League. This after a mediation process overseen by Sports Minister Honorable Charles Bakabulindi yielded dividends. Maroons dragged FUFA to court last week on grounds that it had unfairly been shut out of the top flight league. However, High Court advised Maroons and FUFA to resolve their dispute using an arbiter. Now, after failing to call a truce yesterday, Honorable Bakabulindi managed to convince Maroons to feature in the forthcoming FUFA Big League. This development gives the top flight Uganda Premier League the all clear to run. Uganda Premier League is expected to get underway at some point this month. Now, he may be the only man who can tear pages from Facebook and even pocket while nude, or so he claims. But tonight, Moses Gorilla is playing second fiddle to American Richard Abraham in the height and weight stakes. This as both kickboxers honor today's mandatory weigh-in ahead of tomorrow's intercontinental title fight. Alfred Odong reports.
21 kilograms, with Richard Abraham holding steady at 77 kilograms. The tail of the tape also showed that Abraham is taller than Gola, who will be defending his intercontinental title in tomorrow's fight at the Plush Peak Resort Munyonyo. Abraham is also not short on experience, having 30 fights under his belt, 28 of which he has won. Six of the Americans' victories have been courtesy of knockouts, while Gola on his part has mastered 20 wins from 22 fights he has had. Both kickboxers are in high spirits ahead of tomorrow's fight.
I can't wait, you know, it's going to be me and him in that ring, so, you know, I'm not much for words. I know he likes to talk a lot, but I like to do my talking in the ring, so.
I'm just targeting for the world number one. So it's an honor for me to fight for this intercontinental to defend it. And all the time my people, my fans, they want to see that I really fight good champion. So he's a gold champion. So I believe that people are really going to see the good fight.
The five-round bout will be a full contact low kick challenge, whose winner will stand a chance to get a shot at the world title later this year. Alfred Odong, NTV Weekend Sport.
Now, traditionally, day three of the Uganda Golf Open Championship has been known to separate the boys from the men. Not at this year's edition, though, as tonight the leaderboard of both the main event and professionals categories are watertight. It all looked grim in the morning after torrential downpour forced play to be suspended. The groundsmen, however, put in a shift at the par 71 Kitante course, allowing action to resume. Dewa Kope returned a level par 71 for an aggregate of 210 to maintain a one-stroke lead over Dennis Anguyo. It's also a case of no change in the main event, where Adolf Muhumza holds a three-shot lead over Willie Chitata. A tough buddy putt at the 18th hole saw Muhumza gross 70. Chitata 71 gross has seen him aggregate 219, but he says he fancies his chances tomorrow.
Comfortable to be behind the lead and chase. I feel comfortable chasing rather than being chased. And feeling comfortable, I'm only three shots behind the guy who's in the lead. And I'm comfortable with that. Tomorrow I'll keep on doing what I'm supposed to be doing. Keep on stick on my routine and my rhythm, my swing and everything. I'm not changing anything. Swing strategy for the game is the same. And I'm looking at the victory. Tomorrow's play, I'm not playing for the position like the first three rounds. We are playing for the position and to see how where you'll be standing and all that. But tomorrow is no tomorrow, so it's looking at the victory.
The game today was very, very tough. I missed so many fairways, but I still managed to come back with a 71 level par, which is okay for me. Still puts me in contention. I think tomorrow is another day. We'll try to keep the ball in play.
And we end NTV Weekend Sport with action from across the border, where Roger Federer brought Flushing Meadows to its feet by surviving a full frontal assault from mercurial Frenchman Gael Monfils to reach the semifinals of the US Open. And PSG forwards Zlatan Ibrahimovic has become Sweden's all-time record goal scorer. The 32-year-old netted a brace in Sweden's friendly against Estonia to reach 50 international goals, overtaking Sven, who scored the last of his 49 goals against Finland in 1932.
Roger Federer battled back from two sets down in double match point to defeat Gael Monfils 4-6, 3-6, 6-4, 7-5, 6-2 and reach the semifinals of the US Open. Federer, who will face Marin Cilic in the semifinal, survived a pair of match points when down 15-40 on serve in the 10th game of the fourth set before sealing one of the greatest comebacks the tournament has seen. Frenchman Monfils struck a backhand long to squander his first chance to claim victory, and then Federer denied the 20th seed with a stunning forehand winner to stay in the match. From that point on, Federer took charge by holding serve for 5-5, closing out the fourth set and then breaking Monfils in the first game of the fifth.
I think it was awesome for both guys. I mean, Gael put such a great fight, you know, and he plays such incredible tennis that the crowd has to get into it. And thanks for supporting us, me, if you like, and it helped me to get it done for sure.
Paris Saint-Germain striker Zlatan Ibrahimovic scored twice against Estonia to become Sweden's all-time leading scorer with 50 goals. The 32-year-old opened the scoring with a thumping left-footed volley from a corner after 3 minutes. And Ibrahimovic, making his 99th outing for Sweden, completed the scoring in Solna in the 24th minute with another fine effort as the hosts won 2-0. That goal broke Sven Riedel's tally of 49 goals, which had stood since 1932.
We are optimistic, positive. We are building today a brighter tomorrow by realizing our potential. We are smart, the new mobile network for new Africa. Let's talk.
English Premier League's greatest stars is brought to you by
Guinness. Discover a world of more. Discover a world of more.
And that brings us to the end of NTV Weekend Edition tonight. Thank you for joining me. I'm Rukshana Namuimba. Good night.